Hey guys, I'm Cal, and today I'm going to be showing you how to unlock every free home in The Elder Scrolls Online. Regardless of the version of ESO that you may have purchased, every single player out there should have access to four of these homes, and if you've purchased a full copy of the game more recently, you'll have access to all nine. In total, these free homes include 8 in-rooms and 1 notable home. Even if you don't plan to decorate them, it's well worth it to own all 9 for the convenience they provide. You can fast travel to any home you own from anywhere in the world without any cooldown. So if you're deep in a delve or dungeon and you want a quick trip back to town, housing allows you to do that. Or perhaps you heard about a good deal on crafting materials on the other side of Tamriel. No need to run to a way shrine, just recall to your home in that town. Owning property will also allow you to plop down any furnishings you collect that you want to save without having to give up valuable bank space. And you can increase your storage space with storage chests and storage coffers. Finally, some homes are closer to city services like the Outlaw's Den or the Stablemaster, which means it could actually be safer or more efficient to travel to your home than to a way shrine, even if you can fast travel for free. Plus, you never know when you're going to be ready to admit that housing is the true endgame, and you want to flex your decorating skills and show off all of those trophies you've been earning. Alright, let's get started. I normally play on the PC NA server where I've already unlocked all 9 of these homes, so today I'm switching teams to the EU server where I have no characters and no progression. It's like I'm a brand new player, and I'm going to show you just how quickly you can unlock these free homes. Every character you create can unlock 1 in-room for free, and homes are unlocked account-wide, so even if you delete the characters afterwards, you still keep access to the homes you unlocked with them. And then in addition to the in-rooms, there's 1 home you unlock by completing the first 4 quests of the main storyline of the Elsewhere expansion. I'm going to start with the first 4 in-rooms, which every ESO account should have access to. You're going to need 4 characters for this, 1 from each alliance, and a 4th whose alliance does not matter. The first 3 in-rooms can only be unlocked for free by a member of the alliance where they are located. So you're going to need an Aldmeri Dominion character to get Mara's Kiss, an Ebonheart Pact character to get the Ebony Flask, and a Daggerfall Covenant character to get the Rosy Lion. Then the 4th in-room to unlock is the St. Delon Penthouse in Vardenfell, which can be unlocked by a character of any alliance. In every case, you simply need to travel to the in-room in question and speak to the NPC outside to start the quest. I believe that NPC's name is Falande. You'll progress through the dialogue and then complete the quest. Keep in mind that each character can only get 1 in-room for free, which is why you're going to need 8 characters to unlock all of the in-rooms without spending gold. You can, of course, buy these for just a few thousand gold apiece if you can't be bothered to create the extra characters, but I have literally no gold on the EU server, so I'm going to try and get them all for free. If you want to unlock Mara's Kiss, that is going to be in the Vukul Guard of Aridon, right down here. The Ebony Flask in room is in Stonefalls, right here in Ebonheart. And the Rosy Lion is up here in Glenumbra in Daggerfall, right here, pretty close to the Way Shrine. Now, Mara's Kiss and the Rosy Lion are both right next to a Way Shrine that you will unlock when you start that alliance's storyline. For the Ebony Flask here in Stonefalls, you will actually unlock this Way Shrine over in Davin's Watch, and you're going to have to run along this road to get to Ebonheart here in order to unlock the Ebony Flask. The 4th free in-room that everyone should have access to is up here in Vardenfell. And when you first start the game, you will have this Way Shrine, Sedanin, unlocked, and then you will have to run down the road here and hop into this canton here to unlock the St. Delon Penthouse. Now, beyond these first 4, there are 4 more in-rooms you can unlock. 1 from the capital city of each major expansion zone. So we've got the Golden Griffin in Somerset, the Sugar Bowl Suite in Northern Elsewhere, Snowmelt Suite in Western Skyrim, and Pilgrim's Rest in Blackwood. Much like St. Delon Penthouse, all 4 of these can be unlocked with a character of any alliance. Now, you should have the 8 in-rooms unlocked, which means you've got free fast travel to a major city from each alliance, plus fast travel to the hub city for each of the 5 expansions. Which means it's time to play through the Elsewhere storyline and unlock the crown gem of free housing in ESO, the Hall of the Lunar Champion. The Hall of the Lunar Champion is in the same city as the Sugar Bowl Suite. Its value is not really in unlocking an additional fast travel location, but instead is for its size. This is a notable home, meaning it has the maximum furnishing slots a home can have in ESO. So if you don't plan to leverage it for storage or decorating purposes, it's sort of redundant to the Sugar Bowl Suite. That being said, the Elsewhere storyline is excellent, and there's no reason to not unlock this one. If you stick with ESO long enough, you're probably going to collect dozens of trophies, hundreds of antiquities, and you'll eventually want to unlock all of those storage chests and coffers, as well as build a personal crafting area. But you can't fit all of that in an in-room, so the Hall of the Lunar Champion is a great free option for you. To start this questline, you can open up your map and select the option to start the zone story, or head over to Riverhold and speak with Abner Tharn. Since I'm on a new character on the EU server, I don't have access to any crafted sets or champion abilities, so it took me about 90 minutes to power through, but this questline is totally doable with a day one character. You don't need in-game gear or a lot of experience to get through it. I figured I'd drop some hints here if there were any tricky parts, but it was honestly an experience that really reminded me just how easy the basic content in ESO actually is. Even if you're coming in level one gear with only a couple skills, you can complete the four quests to unlock the Hall of the Lunar Champion. All right, so that took me about 3 hours total, and I've now unlocked free fast travel to 8 cities in Tamriel. I've also got a massive notable home where I can start storing furnishings I collect, and will eventually be able to put all of the storage chests and coffers in a single spot, which will dramatically expand my overall inventory space. If past expansions are any indication, we should be getting a 9th in-room this summer with the High Isle expansion, which would mean a 10th free home for anyone willing to recreate a character or add an extra character slot. If you have any questions about free homes or ESO housing in general, please don't hesitate to leave a comment below, and I'll do my best to reply to all of them. If this video has piqued your interest in ESO housing as well, you should check out some of my other videos. I've got furnishing guides, tips, and tutorials that I'll have linked in the end screen. Thank you all so much for watching today, and I do hope you'll stick around for the next one. I'll be back again next week with another video, but for now, have a great day, and I'll see you then. Bye for now. The most important thing is that 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 the most important thing is